Good day to you all. In this video I'm going to show you the measurements on a coil like this. This is just a copper wire, and over here I have a 100 nanofarad capacitor and two LEDs in anti-parallel. Now the idea behind this all is that I want to work around this point over here, so at around 1 megahertz. And I'm using a capacitor of 100 nanofarad, so that means that I have a coil of approximately 250 nanohenry. And that is a wire of 32 centimeters around, a tube of 9 centimeters diameter. And then over here I bind it together so I can keep the form of the coil. On the setup over here that you are going to measure, so we have the resonance kit coil and a capacitor of 180 picofarad in series. We have the gate driver, the power supply that is going to give us the power. As you can see over here, the 175 microhenry is on this line. So the point for the series is more to here, for that same frequency. So you see there is a difference between them. At the moment I'm building on a coil to try and go higher on this line to see what happens then. But first things first, and I'm going to show you some phase shifting results. So when I now put my single generator on, and it is at 923 kilohertz, then the yellow is the high voltage from our series LC circuit. The green one is the loop that is now installed over here with the two LEDs on it. And it is at the center of the transmitter coil. A little bit to there. We are using 2.4 watts. Now, the most important thing that I want to show you is when I take a third coil, the position where I place it is very important, and you will see it on the phase shift. So at the moment where we can create that phase shift where all the maximums are approximately the same, there we have the best result on the two LEDs. Now it is not that easy with the camera, so it's approximately there, but I'm moving. So when I could keep that sine wave, so around 19 degrees shift between each load, then we see that the both LEDs are approximately the same brightness. But it is hard to keep them at the same place and have the camera. So as you can see now, you can see there are 90 degrees phase shift, and they have both approximately the same brightness. And that is the problem, because when you place them together, you see that they both influence each other. When one goes on, the other goes out, and so further. When you go up, then that goes out and that goes brighter. But if you want the brightness on both to be real interesting, then we must get that approximately 90 degrees phase shift. And then they are both, but you cannot move much. So I need to find a better setup. But I'm going to do much more experimenting before. I'm thinking on making another setup with much more coils and try to align them, but that will be not with a camera, because it's not to do with, as you can see, you can just a slight move and then you are out of the place that you want. That also has to do with the distance between the two coils. So as you can see, they are now... What I'm going to do also is, on this one, the earth connection is first going. So that one over here. So I'm going to do that also for this connection. I had it previous, but due to experiments, there was a change. So back to there. So we can place them very close together and then make the phase shift like that. So if you look at it from the side, so this is approximately the point where we have both. So these are all the three sine waves approximately the same amplitude. So that distance approximately, and then we have the 90 degrees between each sine wave. And as you can see, the power is now 2.5 watts, 2.6, I'm out of tune. So when they are both at maximum brightness, we have 2.2 watts, so our power supply is delivering something less for more output on our LEDs. But of course it is more than the LEDs would use without the LC circuits. So I hope this is interesting also to you. Thank you for watching and hope to see you in the next movie.